Okay. Can you this one? Can you see this one?
Yeah.
So basically, this is related to recursive function. So you understood last time? Last time, did you understand? Recursion. So, are you listening?
Yeah.
Okay. Can you solve this trace table? Or should I help you? These two values are called here. Okay. So can you solve or should I help you?
I can do it.
You can do that? Okay.
Yeah. So X is 0.
Wait a second. X is 0.
Yeah.
Here. Okay. And what about line number?
Five.
5. Okay. Then what will. So you are here.
And then line 6.
Line number
6.
what will be written?
Oh, we have to go back to line 5.
-5. Where?
No, we have to go back to line 5 because it's the recursion.
Here and here. Okay. So now, what will be? We have basically. You have to first. You have to write this one in return column. Okay.
Okay.
So what we have to write here? I just try to.
Two.
Yeah, 2 divisor 2 comma
Two. Zero.
0. Good. That's okay. Okay.
So then we go to line 3.
So what will be line number? Should we go back? Then what will be line number here?
So return
Line number.
0 3.
And what would be here?
X is 2.
And here.
Y is zero.
And then.
Then we return 2.
Okay. So return 2 here.
Yeah.
What will be here? Line number.
3.
So this is solved.
Yeah.
Now move to next. Okay, can you write its Python code?
What?
Can you write its Python code? This one?
Okay.
This one.
Done.
Okay, send to me. Work. That's fine. Okay, now see this one.
Line 5, X is 3.
Line number is
5.
five. Good.
Three. Then return divisor 7, 3 and line 6.
No, what about six? Line number six.
Yeah.
So what we have to write here?
Divisor
Wait, second. Divisor. 7.
seven, 3.
8. Good. Then here.
We go to line 5 again. Wait, no, 0. So
Zero.
write function. So divisor 7, 3.
3. Okay.
Then line 5 again. So now x is 1. Hello?
Yeah. What should we write?
X is 1.
Okay. Then here.
So y doesn't change. Then
Right.
line 6.
So why doesn't it? Okay. So what else? Line number here.
6.
Six. Okay.
Divisor
Divisor.
3, 1.
Three.
1.
Power. Then here.
0.
Zero.
3 and then 1. So then we go to line 5
Five. Okay.
and then x is 0. Then line 6.
Line six. Okay.
A divisor 1, 0. Then line 0.
Line 0, okay.
So x is 1, y is 0. So then we go to line 3.
Line 3, okay.
And we return 1.
Okay, so what about Python code?
Yeah, it's the same as the last one.
So we have basically you have to calculate the return, what will be the value of temp.
Five plus calc 3.
This one.
Wait, but it's going to be 5 plus calc 3.
Say it again. Can you write question? That's right. 5 plus calculate 3. Okay, this is right. Yeah, this is right. Good. good. This is right. That's fine. Yeah. Now you have to find the temp value. Are doing?
Isn't 10 going to be 0?
Yeah, this one you have find, but this one you have to find. What it will return? Basically, you have to unwind.
Wait, but doesn't the final statement make temp 0?
Yeah, 0 plus 1. Will be 1, 0 plus 3, it will be 4 plus 5. This will be the final value. Then you unwind. Okay.
Okay.
You got it?
Yeah.
Now, can you make its Python code?
Okay. Done.
Can you pause?
Yeah, it works. Doing what?
No, I said, can you call this function?
Yeah, I said it works.
This function.
Yes.
Can you add those lines in your sort of Python code? How to
Yeah,
call?
I did. I called it. I'll put it in the chat.
Okay. So, can you state what is meant by recursively defined procedure?
It's when you can call the procedure inside itself multiple times.
Here you can see the definition. A procedure which is defined in terms of itself, or a procedure which makes a call to itself. Anyone you can like it. Procedure call itself.
Okay.
Okay, wait a second. Okay, it's a screenshot. Then you have to solve this. Can you do this?
Okay.
First, you have to take this screenshot yourself, then I will flash here. So you take this screenshot.
Yeah.
This will be in front of you. Now you can go through. you read? Have you understood? What should I write here? Sarah, you got it? Understood?
Yeah.
So, should we start?
So then you have to call
Okay.
X of 2
Two, good.
item. Wait, don't understand what item would be.
Three is not good.
Item would still be 9, right?
Yeah, basically three. Yeah, item is nine. Item is nine.
Okay.
So three is
So we
not.
have to go back.
What did you say?
3 is
What will be here?
right.
Can you write here?
So we go to B.
What should I write here?
Yeah.
Three?
Yeah.
Then?
And 4 in the next one. So then my list of things will become
At four, so basically you are four is basically nine, so nine is equal to nine. Nine greater than equal to nine.
we have to execute line 5 and 6. So my list of 4 will be 13.
30. So where you have I have to write here. Is this right?
Yeah, and
Good.
no, not until this. Yeah, there.
30. At
Yeah.
4, 30. Okay.
Then
I index value.
index is 5.
5. Okay. And then what will be? So
So then my list of 5 would be 16.
16. Good. What is the index value?
And index is 6.
6. Good.
And my list of 6 is 27.
I'd say what I have to write here.
My list six should be 27. Yeah.
27.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, what will be next value?
Index seven. And then we end the procedure.
So what will be here? The value of 7 at 7. At 7.
We end it. No, we end it because my list of seven is. Oh, wait, no, don't end it.
A value will come here. What will be the value
Yes.
here?
So it should be 0.
0. Good. Got it.
Zero.
The index will be 8.
Zero.
Okay, good. Now let me know this one. What will come here? Write the line number from pseudocode shown in part B that shows the procedure X is recursive. How do we know that? You have to tell line number. You can see here. Wait a second, I'll show you that pseudocode. So, which line number shows it is recursive?
Number eight.
Number 8, this one.
Yeah.
Can you write its Python function? Can you write? What did you say? Can you write in chat? Your voice was lagging. Okay.
I sense.
You have passed. Okay. Give me 1 minute. Okay, now see this one. What should I write here?
An algorithm that calls itself.
Function is called. Okay. So here you can see a function or subroutine defined in terms of itself, or a function or something that called itself. So you can write anyone. Create the NaN number and calculate where the recursive call takes place. So which line number? Recursive is being called. So let me know that. Where is that? Yes, Sarah, are you there?
Yeah, I said my.
Can you write line number? Okay, good. That's right. Now take its screenshot, then you have to do this one.
Okay, you go back.
Yeah.
Today,
Can you write? Because your voice is lagging. So call number one.
I asked what you mean by call number.
Basically, you have to see pseudo code, na? Like calculate three. They have given you calculate three using this. It says
So that's kind of.
wait, I place wait a second, I place table here so that it will be easier for you. Now, can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay, so basically you have to call this one. So first, so call number one. What should I write here?
Three.
Okay, we will write here like here, calculate 3. So what will be here?
False.
False. Good. And here?
Wait.
You have to write this one.
Calculate.
This one. Okay. You have to
Yeah.
write. So 3 direct and then calculate
Calculate two.
and bracket.
Two.
So what will be here?
Two.
And here?
Calculate two.
Calculate 2. Here?
False.
False. Good. And here?
Two times calculate one.
Calculate 1. Now here. What should I write here?
Three.
3. Good. And here.
Calculate one.
Good. Calculate 1. And here.
False.
False. And here.
One times calculate zero.
Here.
Four.
From here.
Calculate zero.
Calculate 0. Here.
Two.
Here.
Minus 10.
Minus 10. And what about this one?
Minus 4.
Minus 4. No, minus 60. Okay. Basically, 3 to the 6. Final answer is 60. So basically, 3 to the 6, 6 1 the 6, and here also. 6 10 the 60. Okay. You can write 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1 multiplied by minus 10. Okay. Got it? Yes, Sarah, you got it? Hello.
Oh, you times minus 10. Okay, I thought they just subtracted minus 10.
We basically in when you unwind, so 3 multiplied by 2, 2 multiplied by 1, and 1 multi 3 to the 6, 6 multiplied by 10, so minus 60. You got this one?
Yeah, I just did minus 10. I didn't multiply.
Is this clear?
Yeah, it's clear.
Any idea?
No.
Basically, it says a recursive algorithm within a subroutine can be replaced with an iterative algorithm. So, describe one problem that can occur when running a subroutine that has a recursive algorithm. First, we have. So, basically, here you can see it says each time it call itself, the variable output onto stack. Okay. So, recursion basically handled by stack. Okay. And you know, stack principle is LIFO, last in, first out. So, that is where whenever you have to perform calculation, you have to take out the variable, then perform calculation, then again put in the stack. The function call itself too many times. So, it runs out of stack space or stack overflow. This will, if you have a value too much, if you have greater value, your calculation, right? It can create a stack overflow problem. Got that?
Yeah.
So, enough for today.
Okay.
Okay, see you inshallah on Friday.
Yeah.
Allah Hafiz.
Thank you.